Hello everyone, I'm Lucy Drever, your presenter for this latest Philharmonia session. Welcome to Philharmonia Sessions Orchestra Unwrapped, supported by the Harper Trust with additional support from the Philharmonia Orchestra and Bedford Trust. This performance is free and for everyone. We hope as many people as possible will watch because music has such a special ability to make us feel better. Our supporters' generosity over the last year means the absolute world to everyone at the Philharmonia. And we know how difficult a time it's been, particularly if you've been isolated from your loved ones. With vaccinations now available, there are green shoots of hope for all of us. So, as you watch this concert today, looking at you, mums and dads, grandmas and grandpas, if you're able, please make a donation to help the Philharmonia keep playing for you, your families and friends, wherever they might be in this world. To give, visit philharmonia.co.uk/donate. I hope you enjoy the performance and thank you for your support. Hello everyone and welcome to Philharmonia Sessions Orchestra Unwrapped, supported by the Harper Trust with additional support from the Philharmonia Orchestra and Bedford Trust. It's so wonderful to have you join us. My name is Lucy Drever and our British Sign Language interpreter is Angie Newman. Hi Angie! Behind me is our incredible Philharmonia Orchestra. The orchestra are led by conductor, and today our conductor is Stephanie Childress. Let's all say hello to Stephanie. Hi, Stephanie.
Hi, Lucy. I'm really delighted to be here with you all today.
Through the music that the orchestra plays, they tell us stories. Stories that transport us around the world and through time. Stories that encourage us to see life from a different point of view. Stories that help us understand the world around us, and stories that ignite our imaginations. Every piece of music that you hear today in Orchestra Unwrapped was written by a woman. Women have always composed music, even when they were told they shouldn't or couldn't. But they've not always been remembered in the history books. That means that the musical stories told by women have sometimes been ignored or forgotten. In this concert, we want to highlight some women composers who not only told fantastic stories through their music, but also helped to change society too. During this concert, there will be opportunities to listen, to move, to make sound, and to get creative. But before we do any of that, let's do a quick warm-up to get ourselves ready. Wherever you are, if you can stand up, that would be great. But don't worry if not, and just see if you can make yourself a little bit taller. We're going to be moving our bodies first of all, so just be mindful about the people that might be around you. Can we do some circles with our shoulders? Brilliant, everyone. And forwards. And can you stretch up? And can you stretch out? And can you make yourself as small as possible? And what about as big as possible? And shake one leg. Brilliant, and shake the other. And finally, shake all of that out. Perfect, everyone. Now I'm going to do some sounds and I would love if you copied them back to me. And don't forget about the actions too. Ha, ha, ha. Ha, ha, ha. Eep. Eep. Tss. Work, everyone. The first piece that we're going to listen to today is by Ethel Smyth, a composer, a writer, and a suffragette. Perhaps you've heard of the suffragettes, but if you haven't, the suffragettes fought for women in England to have the right to vote. Ethel Smyth wrote a song, March of the Women, that became the anthem for this movement. In 1918, after many years of campaigning and protest, women who were over 30 and who owned property were legally allowed to vote. One battle had been won, and for some, that was enough. But the fight continued for equal voting rights for all women. Always a pioneer, even before Ethel Smyth joined the suffragettes and the fight for women's rights, she was composing music. Today, we're going to listen to the very first piece that Smyth ever wrote for an orchestra, Serenade in D. A serenade is typically a piece of music sung or played to a particular person, often in the quiet and calm of the night. While you're listening to this piece, can you imagine who Ethel Smyth might have been thinking of? What sort of character do the loud sections make you think of? Is this someone who is important or grand? Perhaps even a historical figure? What about the slower sections or the lively, brisk sections? As you listen, ask yourself, who might this character be and what is their story?
Thank you.
To our orchestra. While we were listening to that piece of music, we were conjuring images and pictures in our mind's eye, and the music was helping us imagine stories. Stephanie, as the conductor, the person leading these amazing instrumentalists, how important is telling the stories to you?
I think telling stories are hugely important, including in music, and I think it's because stories, like music, can be exchanged across cultural barriers, can be interpreted and understood by different people who don't even share the same language. And I think that as a conductor, it's my role to try and bring everyone's story in the orchestra and channel it into one for the audience.
For our next composer, the inspiration for her piece came from real life events. Mary KOUYOUMDJIAN is an Armenian-American composer living and writing music right now. The piece we're going to hear is called Tagh, which is the Armenian word for diary. Tagh is an imagined diary entry of someone who is desperately seeking immigration, a new home in a new country. It tells the story of their hopes and dreams, and then their bittersweet feelings about a life in a place far from home. The piece is performed by our string family, our violins, violas, cellos, and double basses, and it's filled with musical contrasts. Let's listen to how the piece begins. How would you describe this music? And what part of the story does this section tell us? Listen to the first melody, the first tune that we hear played by the cello. If this tune had words to it, what do you think the words could be? The last little bit that we're going to listen to before we hear the whole piece is from the end. Listen to the different atmosphere that the instruments are creating compared to the beginning of the piece. And instead of the cello playing a melody, we hear a higher instrument in the string family, the violin. To the whole piece, think about the character writing the diary entry. How do they feel during the different parts of the journey? And what is it in the music that helps you imagine this? Maybe you want to write down some words or share your ideas with your teacher once the piece is finished.
Thank you.
Next up, it's your turn to make some music. In a moment, we're all going to really get moving. But before we do, let's meet the artists in residence at the Philharmonia Orchestra, House of Absolute, who wrote this brand new piece especially for us. So welcome to Fionn, Faye, and Saskia. Fionn, can you tell us a bit more about House of Absolute?
Hi, yes. House of Absolute are a collective of women. We all dance, we produce music, some of us sing, some of us play instruments, some of us are visual and digital artists, and together we create living art.
And Faye, what's your favourite thing about being an artist?
My favourite thing about being an artist is overriding old rules and systems to embrace the freedom that comes with creativity, to inspire new and energising ways to embrace our future selves.
Saskia, can you tell us a bit about the inspiration for the piece? What's the story?
Sure. The inspiration for this piece is our joy for rhythm, celebrating warriors from all walks of life, because we believe even in times of struggle, we can find ways to have fun, express and energise ourselves.
Amazing. Thank you. So now we're ready to learn our parts for this incredible new piece. We'll go through all the parts right now, but if you want to take a bit more time or have another go later, you can learn all the parts with Serena from House of Absolute over on the Learning Resources page on the Philharmonia website.
We're going to learn the heartbeat section of this piece. So if you've learned this already, you can join in for the practice. We're going to start with rubbing our hearts four times. Let's go together. Ready? One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Change hands. One, two, three, four. Change. One, two, three, four. Once more. Two, three, four. Well done. You're making four circles around your heart and then changing hands and doing that four times all together. For the next section, we're going to do the same heart rubs, but three times and then two quick taps. Let's try this together slowly first. So we go, one, two, three, and then you're going to do two taps, and four, and that's banging your chest with your fist. And then we change hands. One, two, three, and four, change hands. One, two, three, and four, change. One, two, three, and four. Well done. The last section is two taps on the heart with a slight offbeat, changing your hand each time. Watch me first. We go at one and da, two and da, three and da, four and da, five and da, six and da, seven and da, eight and da. Join in. One and da, two and da, three and da, four and da, five and da, six and da, seven and da. And brilliant. And that continues on until the end of the piece. Shall we try it all together? Ready? Here we go. One, two, section one. We go. One, two, three, four, change. One, two, three, four, change. One, two, three, four, change. One, two, with the taps to go. One, two, three, and four. One, two, three, and four, change. One, two, three, and four, change. One, two, three, and four, the taps. One, and a, two, and a, three, and a, four, and a, five, and a, six, and a, seven, and a, eight, and a. Brilliant. And that goes all the way through until just before the end. Now on to Saskia.
For those of you that have already learnt the power and magic sections of our piece, let's try those once through now before we put the whole thing together in performance. For those of you that haven't learned these sections, but would like to in future, there are videos available on the Philharmonia website. Let's start with the power section, which will be performed today by Tom and myself. We start on our thighs and biceps for the first pattern, and around our head and bicep for the second. Let's try. One, two, three, on the thighs. One, and a two, and a three, and four. One, and a two, and a three, and four. Two and a three and four. One and a two and a three and four. One and a two and a three and four. One and a two and a three and four. one, and a two, and a three, and four. Excellent.
And now let's try the magic section with Ollie and myself. This is the trickiest part, so prepare for hand rubs, belly taps, finger clicks, elbows, and your big pose at the end. Let's start with the hand rubs on one, two, three, four.
Thank you, House of Absolute. Let's pull that all together now for the world premiere of Heart Power Magic. Off you go. Congratulations, everyone, and thank you so much to House of Absolute for writing this piece for us. You can learn all these rhythms in your own time online through our website. What new rhythms can you create? Make your own warrior rhythm at home and keep moving together strong. Our next piece of music is by Louise Ferenc, another inspirational and pioneering composer. Louise Ferenc lived in France in the 1800s. In her time, she was an incredibly famous pianist and became a composer, even though only men were allowed to study composition at the time. She was the first ever female professor at the Paris Conservatoire, a place that specializes in the study of music. She was hardworking, talented, and gained much success, but she was still paid much less than her male colleagues. She protested and demanded equal pay. After 10 years of fighting, she won. The piece we're listening to today is Ferenc's Overture No. 1. After the very regal beginning, you'll hear the oboe playing a melody closely followed by three other members of the woodwind family, the bassoon, the flute, and then the clarinet. Let's have a listen. Listen to the whole piece, you'll hear that as well as beautiful melodies, this piece is full of drama and power too. Perhaps when you listen, you can hear some of the story of Louise Ferenc's fight to be treated fairly and the battle for her stories to be heard.
Thank you.
To finish off today's concert, we have a piece of music that I think you'll recognise. It was written for the 2013 film Frozen and has won numerous awards all over the world. In Frozen, two sisters, Anna and Elsa, must overcome hardship and go on an epic journey to save the kingdom of Arendelle. But did you know that the character of Elsa was originally written as a villain? It was when the songwriters Anderson Lopez and Lopez took this song to the producers that it was decided that the plot should change and tell the story of how Elsa learns to embrace her gifts. And the two sisters discover that when they work together, they are unstoppable. Our audience's generosity means so much to the orchestra. If you're able to make a donation, large or small, this will help the Philharmonia keep playing with the same gusto we've seen in this concert. Visit philharmonia.co.uk/donate to give. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us today, for learning the body percussion piece, Heart, Power, Magic with us, and for listening to all this music by these inspirational and pioneering composers. Playing Let It Go, this is the Philharmonia Orchestra. Thank you.